In Wwise, objects exist within a parent-child hierarchy and are displayed in a hierarchical structure. A child object has a parent, and that parent has its own parent, and so forth. All of these objects can contain settings such as bus assignments, volume, and pitch, but it's important to understand that the children inherit these settings from their parent. For property values like pitch, inheritance occurs in a cumulative fashion. Let's say that these are pitch values for these four objects. When the object at the bottom of the hierarchy is played, the pitch property settings from all of the objects above are summed together to create the value that will be used at the time the sound is played. Let's see how this works in an actual project. Here is a project with various sound SFX objects that contain some dialogue.
Intruder alert.
I'll offset this first object's pitch value to -600 cents. When we play it,
Intruder alert,
we can hear that it's been transposed down about a half octave. Now, for organization, as well as group control, we can place all of these objects within another type of object called an actor mixer. First, we'll select them, right-click, and choose New Parent, Actor Mixer. And we'll name it Entry Voices. We can see that the actor mixer has its own pitch property, and we'll set this one to +600. If we expand the actor mixer, we can see this first sound SFX object again, and we'll play it.
Intruder alert.
We can hear that it's gone back to its original pitch, even though the pitch property says -600. This is because it's been offset by the +600 value that we entered in its parent actor mixer. If we play any of the other objects within the actor mixer that we didn't adjust their original pitch, we'll hear that they play at a higher pitch.
Drainage system access granted.
It may seem that the actor mixer is at the top of the hierarchy, but there's more hierarchical structure than first meets the eye. In order for any of these sound SFX objects to be heard, their audio signals must be sent to an audio bus. Audio buses exist within the master mixer hierarchy. In the master mixer hierarchy, all projects contain a master audio bus. If we expand the master audio bus, we can see that we already have a music audio bus contained within that we'll use later. We can create an additional audio bus specifically for the entry voices. Just choose the master audio bus, click the Create New Bus icon, and name it Entry Voices. Currently, none of the Entry Voice Sound SFX objects are feeding into this Entry Voices bus. We can change this back in the Actor Mixer hierarchy. By default, the top parent of a hierarchy dictates the bus routing assignment for all of the children contained within. By selecting the Entry Voices Actor Mixer, we can see it's assigned directly to the master audio bus. Reassigning it is as simple as dragging the desired bus to the output bus property assignment. In this case, we'll drag the Entry Voices audio bus into the output bus assignment. Now, if we click any of the entry voices within the Actor Mixer, we can see that they are now assigned to the Entry Voices bus. However, their assignment is grayed out because this assignment is inherited from its parent. If we needed to make an exception for one of the children, we could choose to override the parent and then freely assign that object to whichever bus we want. However, we'll leave this one the way it was. So here's the current structure of this project that we've created so far. You can see that this structure spans both the actor mixer and the master mixer hierarchies. Now that we understand this, it's very important to understand that objects in the master mixer hierarchy also have property offset control over the objects that feed them. Let's see how this works. Let's go back and select the entry voices audio bus we just created. We see that it also has a pitch property. In this case, we'll set it to +1200 cents, or a full octave. Now, when we play any of the objects that feed this bus, the number is also being applied in the summing of the pitch property values. There's even a property control on the master audio bus, which represents the very top of the hierarchy. We'll go ahead and set this to -1200 cents, just for demonstration purposes. Now, you'd want to be careful adjusting a property like pitch here in the master audio bus, as this offset is applied to every object in the entire project.
Intruder alert.
So as you've just learned, there's a bridge between the actor mixer hierarchy and the master mixer hierarchy that's not immediately evident just by looking at your objects in the Project Explorer. To get a better overall look at the hierarchical structure, you can use the schematic view. In the main menu, choose Layouts, Schematic. At first, you can see the master audio bus, but as you continue to expand the objects, you can see the hierarchical relationship all the way down to the audio source that feeds the sound SFX object. In fact, you can even view the properties that we've been adjusting. Click the Schematic View Settings icon. Move to the Properties, select Voice Pitch, and click OK. Now you can see all of the pitch property offset values that are being factored in each time a sound SFX object is played. Now, let's take one more look at the inheritance system and how we can see it at work in real time using a feature called the Voice Profiler. In this case, we'll see how changes to volume can affect this music soundtrack. We'll expand the Music Actor Mixer to see the Sound SFX object and start playback. Now choose Layouts, Voice Profiler. Now we'll start a capture session, and down below, we can see that the cube main theme is being referenced. If we select it, we can see a similar hierarchical structure showing the different parts of the Wwise system that are acting on the sound. We can also see numeric values for things like volume offsets listed over on the far right side, as well as a graph at the bottom. Now, if we start making changes to things like the voice volume, we can see and hear the changes. In this case, if we choose the Music Actor Mixer, we'll add a little bit of value. We can see the cumulative effect. If we keep working our way up the hierarchy, any adjustments are shown in the final calculations. Here, we can easily trace all of the changes to volume properties, starting with the voice volume in the Sound SFX object, working our way up to the master audio bus, and seeing in this situation the final offset value of -3 dB.